Recently, in a comment thread, a somewhat prominent Bible scholar, he went so far as to call the flat earth a cancer. And I've heard a lot of derogatory things said over the last couple of years about flat earth, but that one was particularly painful. But when I just think about the continuing number of people that I come across whose lives have been changed in all kinds of ways, whether they find God out of atheism or occultism, or whether they just go from having a very nominal and shallow faith to one that is so much deeper and rooted, and the Bible goes from being something that is just this confusing mass of metaphor to being something that they know in their heart is literally true. And I just personally can't get enough of listening to these kinds of stories and people's testimonies, and so here are some more of them. I was brought up through a Christian church by my dad. For 17 years of my life, I would go to church but not really be dedicated to it. Going through all of this school stuff, it drew me astray from believing in a God. There wasn't one part of me committed to the belief that there was a higher power. I was agnostic. I didn't care whether there was a God or not. Last year, for some reason that seems completely miraculous, flat earth was introduced into my life. There was no reason for me to even explore the topic. I still can't remember how it even began. Something drew me to it out of nowhere. I am now a believer in Yahuwah. Every night I pray to him, and I always look to the sky to admire its beauty. I feel alive. These last few years were a decline for me, depressed, thinking everything was pointless. But now I have the strength and wisdom to see past it. The Holy Spirit is with me. I audibly cheered when a certain account affirmed that they had come to the conclusion that God is right there. If the earth was truly flat, then that would have to mean that Jehovah is right there. When I realized this most obvious and sobering thought, I was laying in bed, and I literally got up. Walking down my narrow corridor, I felt my heart begin to race like it would during the excitement of seeing a loved one or a dear old friend. I came through my front door, and a clear night sky became my new ceiling. I felt my eyes take in the majesty of its sky. And for the first time in my 32 years of existing, I felt like God truly was right there looking back down at me. Me, some insignificant, selfish, sinning wretch. But this whole time, he's been right there. Always. And now I don't feel any of those things about myself. While I will always be a sinner as I am human, through God and his son's selfless gift, I am renewed. Cleansed. God said, "Have no love for this world, not even to act as if you were part of it. Because this world, this system is false, tasteless, fruitless. God is the only truth. Be strong, brothers and sisters. It will soon be a paradise once again, as was intended." I've experienced a very similar awakening to the ones expressed by the others sharing their testimonies. I now realize that the Bible did not make sense because we are out of context. I always thought that the Bible was out of context, but reading it under the scientism umbrella with its gravity, spinning balls, evolution, distant galaxies, the overarching sense of insignificance it elicits, it was very difficult to accept its teachings. I was amazed when I realized that flat earth was the answer, the missing link in this vastness of nothingness we are programmed to believe. Without the connection to our flat earth, to our sense of purpose, to our creator, we are easily manipulated into a world of materialism and perpetual ignorance. Learning about the flat earth has brought me closer to God. I now feel a sense of purpose, a sense of belonging, a sense of direction. Evil is hard at work and all around us, I can see that now. All you have to do to find God is keep an open mind and not be so eager to defend all the nonsense we were taught in school, that ego, that ignorant pride. Seek and you will find God. I'm a Christian, but I've started to despair just thinking about the expanse of the universe and where was God. Maybe everything was a fluke. I can never understand this third heaven stuff, firmament, etc. And then, like coming out of the darkness and into the light, flat earth forever, I drew to it immediately. Life makes sense now, and the confusion is gone. I was confused and knew that I was, I just couldn't understand why, but now I do. I believed the Bible and been a Christian from a young age, but had the standard public school science education. I started to question it when forced to watch Cosmos every Friday in earth science class, 7th grade. I knew it was wrong, but not why or how. I feel the same way about these scientific evidences for flat earth as I did 25 years ago finding the young earth creation flood evidences. I feel like a short circuit between my faith and my intellect has now been rewired and repaired. God's truth outlasts all of man's lies. I have the same story as many. When I finally realized the earth was flat and motionless, and I've been lied to since birth, I first cried out of anger, then tears of joy, I found the truth. We have a creator, and I understand that now. After 9/11, I began a search for the truth in all things. I began to look into conspiracies and got further down the rabbit hole. I came across Flat Earth in November 2016 when I watched a video by Vsauce attempting to debunk Flat Earth. Being the first Flat Earth video I watched, it made me query it and search further, and now I know the truth. I was always a follower in Christ, but with all the truth-seeking, my viewpoint of creation and the world we live in became questionable. On my discovery of Flat Earth, my faith in Christ is stronger than ever. God bless. I've been trying to explain how my life is at ease since I found about Flat Earth. They question me, okay, so what if it is flat then? I try to describe how much difference on your life choices it makes. You know what I'm talking about. You get this weight of stress out of your mind and soul knowing the most powerful fact that it proves that there is a God, a creator. It gives us so much meaning in life. Nothing baffles me. I could care less for material things. Love, peace, and happiness is all I need. God is good. It completely changed my view on everything. I admired our creation more. It's so detailed. It's a wonderful feeling. I feel the connection with the real you and our Savior. No one approached me about this in my discovery of it. I had heard about an acquaintance of mine saying that it was flat, and I laughed it off, but a few months later, the thought came to mind. I watched a video by Celebrate Truth called Biblical Proof of the Flat Earth, and he said something that changed everything for me, and that was to take off the blinders and read Genesis chapter 1 all over again. I decided to take the blinders off when reading everything. Joshua telling the sun to stand still drove the nail in the coffin for me, and then I started seeing all the natural research associated with this. It's truly been a gift, and the revelations on it keep getting deeper and deeper. What saddens me is, believers, even many leaders, have learned how to operate within NASA's paradigm, not really thinking about the fact that the flat earth helps our case more than it hurts it, because anyone reading the Bible, if they are honest, can tell based on the endless passages, if taken exactly how they are written, can see that the Bible is not a heliocentric book at all, and many unbelievers know this. I've been sharing this one person at a time, and many have opened their eyes to this, and as a result, the word is opening up to them. I too found Flat Earth and Jesus close together around August of 2016. God draws out his people through Christ. I found God to be true when I started looking into the occult and seeing how evil really does rule this world. Then at the end of 2014, I stumbled across the Flat Earth, or better yet, I was given this truth. Now I know God is really above the North Star and we live in his created realm. And now I can see the darkness clearly and see the demons and unclean spirits that deceive everyone. I can also sometimes see the light and feel the Holy Spirit that has power over this darkness and deception. I can't believe how real all this is and how I wish I can show everyone. Before researching Flat Earth, I considered myself an agnostic. There is a God, prove it. There is no God, prove it. With the intent of being open-minded, because I had no way of proving either, and I didn't. Both faith and science, or shall I say scientism, have holes in them. I enjoy science, but I knew deep down inside something just wasn't right. I now know what science and pseudoscience is. Flat Earth research the last few months was such a change. And at first when it clicked for me, it was hard, very hard to accept. Not exaggerating when I say this. I had trauma, shock, moments of terror, hot and cold sweats. Waking up in the middle of the night crying. So many shrouds unveiled, uncloaked at once, and doing my best to accept so much of my life and beliefs were false and forgiving myself. It was overwhelming. I reflect back now and realize how hurtful pride can really feel. Out of all the sins, in my opinion, pride leads the pack. I look at the world differently, the skies differently. I feel like a huge lens has been torn off. I can't remember what vid it is at the end of it. You said that Jesus loves me very much. I smiled and cried at the same time. It's true. Jesus is real. He loves everyone. We just need to see it gently. I've been a believer in all my life in that classic roller coaster way. Flat Earth has not just revitalized, but transformed my walk. The Bible has become brand new to me. My studies are deeper, my conversations with Yahweh more personal. My very perception of life has been permanently altered. The only thing better than the Flat Earth leading me back to Christ after 19 years as an atheist rejecting God is watching your videos of testimonies. knowing that countless others are experiencing the same life-changing salvation in the most unimaginable way. A Christian all my life, but 2 years ago, riddled with fear over picturing the spinning earth flying through space. I got counseling, and then I prayed and fasted, and God led me to the truth of His creation, the still, unmoving flat earth. Here's my testimony. You guys should go check this out. I was raised a Christian, then left the faith when I was indoctrinated in science and debunking the creation account. Then I found Kent Hovind, and seeing evolution as a hoax led me back to Jesus Christ, but I can admit now that I was sincere in my beliefs, but there was still a bit of doubting Thomas until flat earth. Even after the 9/11 conspiracy, the banking system and its rulers, and flat earth tied it together and made my faith cemented in Christ and His creation that we live in. When I prayed after learning about flat earth, I cried tears of joy and fear of what it means is truly coming, and if not for this tie, and took all of my loose conspiracies and showed me the loop, the circuit of lies it took to make this global earth believable. I now laugh at it, but it truly kept me from falling fully into my Christianity. Remember now, look up, await His return. Help others get saved and keep spreading the word. I love you all that are in this with me. I know we all feel alone in this at times, but we are not alone. We are all members of the body of Christ. I would like to add my testimony to the others. I was raised Catholic, went to Catholic school, which is void of the Holy Spirit, for most of my formative years. Verse after verse of the Bible was thrust upon me with no context, no passion, and no love by the people who did not understand or believe it themselves. I quickly became an agnostic, and once I entered public high school, I began to question even my agnosticism and teetered on becoming an atheist. I fantasized about space travel and ate up anything about space and science I could get my hands into. I had questions and doubts about the validity of many of the scientific models and concepts I had learned, but never dared voice publicly for fear of shame, ridicule, or in doubt in my own intelligence. So I just took what I was told regarding most things as true because I had trust in both the world and men. Looking back, I was never happy, just content. I joined the Marine Corps right out of high school in an effort to inject meaning and substance into my life, which worked to an extent, but I was still not truly happy. I ended up getting injured in Iraq by an IED and teetered on death's doorstep for a while. I cannot explain what happened to me, but when I gained my health again, the whole experience left my soul rather void. Being in the hospital, seeing so much pain and misery in my brothers had taken a toll on my heart. I left the hospital with the question, why, burned into my heart. This inspired me to delve headfirst into the infamous rabbit hole in a desperate attempt to answer the burning question. Shortly after realizing the depths of evil that exist in the world, I figured there must be a God. Out of fear, hope, and curiosity, I sought to understand Him as best I could. I started studying various religions with the same passion which I had when I was learning about science and space. It was overwhelming to say the least, and after a few years, I found myself hardly any further along in my spiritual game I was playing. Being the stubborn individual that I am, it took a series of emotionally traumatic events to get me to even consider taking a second look at Jesus. I thought since I was raised a Catholic that I already had a good grasp of the deal and found it lacking. How foolish was I? In retrospect, what I was looking for had been in front of my face the whole time. I was like a child with a perfectly prepared and delicious meal put on their table, which I ignored and instead demanded my dessert. How selfish was I? After I decided to look into Jesus again, in my heart I began to feel something I had not felt since I was a young child, happiness and comfort. I danced around the issue for a few more years out of fear of being judged by others because of the negative stereotypes I associated with Christianity these days. But slowly and surely the seed was sown and had sprouted. Eventually my ego caved in and I admitted to myself and others that I am indeed a Christian. I still did not understand what it meant as I took the Bible quite metaphorically. I could not fathom a way to reconcile my reality with the biblical reality. Then flat earth popped up. I mocked it at first like we all did, but just like my faith in Jesus, its seed was sown, sprouted, and blossomed. The proof is there for all to see, placed in front of you on a silver platter, and again I feel that stubborn child demanding his dessert while neglecting a perfect meal. Finally, I was able to see a way that the Bible could be literally true. I started reading it for the first time in my life without a critical spirit, but one of openness and respect. I understood passages and stories that I never had before. I saw the wisdom, truth, and love that is in it. I knew it was of God, and there was no doubt left. Needless to say, I have no trouble reconciling my reality with biblical reality. I realized that my reality had always been, and is now, and always will be, the biblical reality, as it is all of our reality, the only reality. This fallen world now makes sense, and I have the answer to the question that burned a hole in my heart, as well as a miraculous healing of the wound that burning had caused. I feel whole and complete, and I will share what I have found to anyone who listen. How happy am I?